You see, the topic is the liver-brain connection, an insight into a disease referred to as hepatic encephalopathy. As we all know that liver is a huge, the largest metabolic machinery that is present in our body. And amongst the several functions, one of its most important functions is detoxification. What it does, it detoxifies the toxins and renders them harmless. So in a condition when the liver is not functioning properly, then what happens is the toxins, they get accumulated. And that time, it causes loads of problems, and one of them, it affects the nervous system. And so when, due to liver dysfunction, the brain is not able to function properly, we use this term as hepatic, which is liver, and encephalopathy means brain disease. So this is actually the definition, which states as a spectrum of neuropsychiatric abnormalities, which is characterized by variable degree of motor and cognitive deficit. Now, there are various categories according to the extent of liver damage. So if the liver is severely damaged, which we call the acute condition, then we categorize it as a type A encephalopathy. In case of type B, it is associated with a portal systemic bypass, but no evident liver disease. And the type C, which is the most prominent, or rather it occurs at the high rate, that is encephalopathy associated with cirrhosis. Now this can be further subdivided into three types, that is episodic, persistent, and minimal. Amongst them, my work is actually on minimal hepatic encephalopathy. There's a reason to it that in minimal, it is very important to diagnose it. So both, actually it needs loads of neuropsychiatric tests, behavioral tests. So most of the cases it happens that patients are not aware that they are suffering from minimal HE. So by the time it is actually detected, almost it has reached a level of persistent HE, which is more harmful for the patient. This is a slide showing prevalence. And in the pie chart, I've shown about what are the various causes that may cause liver cirrhosis, the type C1. The prominent being hepatitis C, hepatitis C alcohol related, and many other toxins and factors. Amongst them, as you can see, that it has no barrier. It can occur to people of any age, any gender, all over the world. And that is why it is a matter of great concern, and is obviously clinician, researcher are equally working hard on it. Most of this patient with cirrhosis, as is shown, that 45% they have overt HE, and 80% actually suffer from minimal. I just now told you the importance why the minimal is of great concern. So this is a slide representing the same. So why it is so important? HE impacts all aspects of health-related quality of life. So the patient is a great sufferer, no doubt. It has sleep disturbance, it affects his driving ability, as I've said that, it affects his motor coordination. Emotional behavior, your workplace behavior, social family interaction. But at the same time, it is equally a burden for the caregivers or those people who are taking care of such people. So it has a lot of social relevance other than its clinical importance. Now, I'll give you a brief insight as to its molecular understanding of this disease. Now, there are several theories as the thing goes on. One of the most prominent among is this ammonia. Now, we all take proteins, we all take different type of foods. So what happens is, your gut-derived metabolite, they are broken down, and ultimately the end product is ammonia. This ammonia is highly toxic. So in your liver, we all have urea cycle. So what it does is, this ammonia is rendered harmless and converted to urea. So in a condition where your liver is not functioning properly, so what happens, this ammonia goes on accumulating. And this condition is referred to as hyperammonemia. So ammonia can easily reach your brain. Under normal circumstances, this ammonia is rendered harmless by converting into an ammonium ion. But in condition when it increases and it reaches your brain, then it causes loads of problems. And obviously, so much of research work, so much of work has been done. So obviously, treatments have come out. But these treatments are not a full-term cure. They are like managing or helping to help you with the disease condition a little bit better. Amongst them, as I've said, that one of the important factors is accumulation of ammonia. So what we can do is reduce its level. So like in the market, the doctors prescribe is like lactulose, L-ornithine or L-aspartate. Other than this, they give many neurotransmitters for their proper brain functioning. In case of acute, there is no other way other than to have liver transplantation. But we all know the problem of organ donation is such a huge problem in our country and everywhere else as well. Or you can control your diet. These are some of the basic things that I have stated. There are huge many other things. So take good control of your liver. We'll all be able to function properly. So thank you for your patient hearing.